Hi folks, so I got more done on the Minibus kitchen cupboards. I've got them all glued and screwed together now. I did video the process of assembling it, but it wasn't that interesting to make a video solely about that. So I just tack in a small montage of what I did here. So today, what I'm going to get on with is cutting the holes for the doors and finding some wood to make the doors for the front one. So I'm going to make a start here, marking up the rear cupboard. Now I've got the front fastened on just with screws at the minute, just so I can take them off for cutting. But to mark them out, I think it's quite important to have them fixed to the cupboard. So that when I'm marking it, everything stays square. And this is the easiest cupboard to do because there's just two cutouts, one for the bottom, one for the top. On the front cupboard there's three and they're for doors, whereas this is just for cubbies. Okay, hopefully you can see that. The outline for the bottom cubby and then the top cubby there. So we get these cut out and see how they look. So I'm going to start off just by drilling the corners out with this forstner bit. But before I do that, I'm going to take the front of the cupboard off so it's a bit easier to work with. Right, now I've got all those holes cut, next thing I'm going to do is my least favourite part, and that is cut out the rest of this with the jigsaw. I absolutely hate using the jigsaw. But we'll see how it goes, and hopefully I don't end up with just wavy lines. Didn't go too bad.
It's a fairly straight cut, so not too bad at all. Now just to repeat it another 7 times and hopefully get the same result.
So there you go, that's the front on the rear cupboard, just roughly sitting in position just now. Still got a tiny bit, just a bit of finished sanding around these corners. And then that will be done, ready for fastening on, and then covering. Still got to figure out the holes for the seat belts going through. I'll do that before I cover it, but yeah, that's looking decent. Right, that's it all sanded. I went and rounded these edges off slightly, just so they're not sharp when you're brushing against them when you're taking things out of the cubby. And to sand it, I used one of my Airbauer palm sanders that I got with my eBay job lot of tools for £16. So that came in very handy to get inside these edges. So well impressed with that. So now I'm just going to put the front back on. I might need to take it off again to do something else, but I'll put it back on for safekeeping. Right, now I've got that one done, and move on to the more complex one, the front cupboard. So that's got three openings, and I've also got to fit doors on it. So it's a bit more complex, but we'll get it marked out in a similar way, and then
I'll have to adjust for details like that gas door. It's going to need a very thin edge this side for the hinge, because otherwise once the door's open, I'll not be able to get the gas bottle in if I leave too thick an edge on it. Same with the bottom. Through the bottom, I don't want any lip to stop being able to slide the gas bottle in. So I want to mark it up carefully, but obviously I can look like the lights of the lip and stuff. I'll be able to sand it down if I don't get it exact. So wish me luck. Okay, for this front cupboard, I'm going to do it a bit differently than I did with the back. I'm going to do one hole at a time. Just so I can figure out what size hole I need, what size door, what the overlap's going to be, and because that affects the size of the other holes. So I'm going to start off just by drilling out this and checking that these line up in the right places inside, because some of my measurements when they're level on this outside don't seem to line up with the previous marks I've made, so I just want to check that everything's copacetic before I go on and cut the rest of the holes. So I just drilled the hole in the corner there, and it feels alright. It's not overlapping. Well, there is a slight lip here, but that's probably going to work out alright. So hopefully if I drill this top one, in fact I'm going to drill a bigger hole in the middle here. You know what, in fact I could just cut out the centre here. Yeah, I think I'll do that, just cut out the rough centre, and then I can go and cut the edges once I've measured that they're all going to be alright. So I'll do that with a jigsaw, cut myself a rough centre hole out, and then I can see exactly where I'm cutting to. Right, so now I've got a rough hole, I can see where this upright is and where this shelf is. So what I'm going to do now is just going to drill some exploratory holes just in here, using this special saw bit. So if I drill a hole, then I can saw up to the edge so I know exactly where that edge is. Alright, so we'll do that now. That feels like it's going to be good to go, so I think I'll just drill the corners out now, and we'll go for it. So it's back to the frost in a bit, drill all four corners, and then I'll finish off with the jigsaw. And there you go, that's the gas door cut. What we're going to do now is just check that the gas bottle will fit in. Check it fits. So that's perfect fit in there now. I will be fitting a strap to secure the bottle fully in place. But yeah, that's the gas door done. Oh, the opening for the gas door. Still got to get doors. And I think I'm going to do that now. And find some wood to make this door, so I can get the door cut, so that will show me what surround I'm going to have, and then I can trip over, and then I can measure for the other holes. So I'm here in the wood hoard, we've got a fair bit, and I'm looking for some furniture board. I need two pieces at 33 by 25 and one at 60 by 15, and that's a 15 mil furniture board that I'm wanting. So we've got all this stuff. This is all old. I think that's my old sideboard. That's quite a big piece. I'm just going to have a look at these over here. That, which is, it's a bit bigger than, slightly bigger than 15. What's this? That's 15, that's what I'm wanting. Look at the size of that. Shucks. No, hold on. I need 25 by 33. That'll do one piece, that'll do one door. I'll see if there's any more of that behind here. Nope. And I think it's in there. There should actually be some doors in here. So the doors. I'll probably do another one. That piece there looks like it will do the top door. What do I need? 15. Yep, 60 by 15, so it's definitely wide enough. And we'll check lengthwise. And 60's there, so that's definitely long enough. Perfect! So, it certainly pays to have a wood hoard. There's me, got my three pieces that I need to do the doors. So just get these cut to shape and size, and whack them on. Right, so that's the one, the gas door cut to size. Just did a bit of a modification on the width and the height, just to get them to line up better with the lines that I wanted them to line up with. And obviously they're not fastened on yet, it's just balancing there. You can see the hinges and the way they're going to fasten on. I am going to be rounding off these corners just to give it a bit more style. So they're not just square cupboards, just so it's a bit more in line with the way that looks. So I'll round them off, but first I'm going to get all the holes cut out for these cupboards and get the cupboard doors cut, and then I'll get to rounding off and fixing hinges and stuff. But it's coming on, as you can see. Pretty good progress so far, I think. We're going to leave it here today and come back to it tomorrow with a fresh mind and fresh body, hopefully. Been a bit sore the past few days, so that's why I've not got a lot done. But thanks for watching so far. Bye for now.